Hi, everyone. Hi, everyone.
Hello.
Oh, thank you. Public speaking is not easy, so I need more motivation from you. Okay, I thank all of you for coming today for my presentation, and I'm very happy for that. And I hope that at the end of my presentation, you will learn more about Cameroon in general and the Western region in particular regarding traditional part, because my presentation today is tradition in Western region of Cameroon. And before I go deep to the subject, I will say that in Cameroon, in general, we have many proverbs, many citations, and each case has its own proverb. So for this traditional part, I choose those two proverbs. Culture is all we have left when we have lost everything, and a man without culture looks like a zebra without stripes. So the culture is an important thing in our tradition. So the outline, let me present you my outline, is introduction, presentation of Cameroon and West region, because it's good to know where is Cameroon and Western region before learn about tradition. And the tools always used. Now I will start the traditional part by the Lakam, the cult of schools, Kugan dance, personal testimony, and conclusion. So introduction. The people from West region of Cameroon are called Bamileke, and it's my native region. I'm from a Bamileke girl, and normally they say that it's the largest ethnic group of in Cameroon. It's just because the Bamileke are everywhere in Cameroon. Everywhere you go in Cameroon, you will find Bamileke, even in the world. The proof is that here am I in U.S. as a Bamileke. So we are everywhere. And our culture is characterized by rituals. So rituals, ceremony, all our ceremony is rituals and practice with the help of many tools. You will see those tools. And in general, Bamileke people, they are very spiritual in general. And all our tradition is composed of initiation practice, as I said. And we are very attached of our tradition. Me too, I'm very traditionalist. I usually say that to my friends, that I like my tradition. And I'm jealous of my tradition. And also, we strongly believe in the power of our custom. So I recommend you to stay at the till the end of the presentation, because I will make a personal testimony. It's my story. Why we strongly believe of our custom. I will tell you my story. And now the first point is the presentation of Cameroon and the Western region. First of all, Cameroon, where is Cameroon situated? Cameroon is situated in Africa. This is the map of Africa, and Cameroon is in red color. And as you usually say, I'm from Cameroon, Central Africa. I like that. And Cameroon is a laic country. In Cameroon, we have many religions. We don't have an official religion. No, we have Christianism, Muslim, animist, free thinker, and other religion. And also, Cameroon is a bilingual country. We have English and French as official languages. We don't have a native language as official language, because Cameroon has 250 ethnic groups. And it's not easy, till now, it's not easy for the government to choose one dialect and make it as official language among 250 ethnic groups. And Cameroon has 10 regions, and we have, over 10 regions, we have 2 English-speaking regions and 8 French-speaking regions. So the majority of population in Cameroon is French-speaking, like me. And yes, this is the essential of Cameroon. Now the Western region, of course, is situated in the Western region of Cameroon. And the Western region has 8 departments. I have a precision concerning Cameroon. In Africa, we call Cameroon Africa in miniature, because in Cameroon, wherever you come from in Africa, you will find yourself in Cameroon. Regarding maybe traditional part, maybe food, maybe habit, maybe language. So Cameroon is kind of a mixture of all Africa in general. So we call it Cameroon in miniature. And now, let me come back from the West region. The West region has 8 departments. And each department normally has an official called official dialect. We call it, for example, from my native department, which is Nde department here, our native official language is Manjumba. But inside this Nde department, is divided into districts, and each district is divided into villages, and each village is divided into neighborhoods. And in this Nde division, we don't understand ourselves. We have many also, each district has its own language. For example, my parents are from Nde division, but not from the same district. My mother is from Bazu, her native language is Bazu, and my father was from Bangulab, and there is also another language there, and sometimes it's not easy to understand, when, especially for young people. It's not easy to understand when someone from Bazu speak and the other one from Bangulab. It's not easy to understand. And even in Bangulab, for example, my native village, it's divided into neighborhoods. And each neighborhood has its own language. It's the same language, but there is a difference regarding the intonation, the pronunciation, the accent. And this difference is not is not easy perceptible by young generation. Only elderly, when you speak to an elderly person, he immediately recognizes your neighborhood. You say, oh, you are from this neighbor, because of your accent, because of your speaking, your intonation. And it's the same from this department, Menwa, is the department, native department of my husband. The principle is the same. So there are many villages and many headquarters, neighborhoods, and the language are different. When someone from one headquarter neighborhood speak, there is a difference. You can understand, you can see the difference. And despite those differences regarding languages and the thing we have in common is the tradition. This tradition is the same in the West region in general. Despite those departments, and the principle of the tradition is the same. Maybe it's the difference is maybe on the time. In one department, maybe they will make this tradition in the morning, in another, maybe in the afternoon or in the night, but the tradition, the principle is the same. Before talk about the tradition, I will present you here the tools we usually use for those traditions. And those tools are for sacrifices. You have juju, white one, because the color is white. You have color nut, tree of peace. You have palm oil, salt, goat, chicken. It's for when we make our sacrifices. And those two are for dances. You have clothes of tradition, ponytail, feather hat, gong, tam-tam. And in the West region, it's not possible to see a traditional ceremony without those, it's a traditional dance without those tools. It's impossible. And during my presentation, I will show you some video. And if you look careful, you will recognize some of those tools in those videos. Now I'm talking about tradition. And I will start with this lakam, the ceremony. What is lakam? Lakam is a secret house. This ceremony happens when the village will have a new king. The characteristic of this lakam ceremony is that the future king of the village spend 9 weeks in this secret house with 9 notables of the village, and those 9 notables are here to initiate the future king, to give him power, to tell him the secret of the village, to teach him how he will manage the village at the end of the lakam ceremony. And the future king is not alone in this lakam, in this secret house. He went there with several women. And women here have a role to prove that we have a viril king. Because those women have the obligation to get pregnancy inside this lakam ceremony. And we hope that at least one woman will get pregnancy for a baby boy. And this baby boy will be the future king after the death of his father. If at the end of the ceremony, non woman get pregnancy, it means that this man is not a good chief, a good king for the village. And because he was already inside lakam, which is the secret house, it's not possible to go out without reach all goals, all criteria, without filled all steps. And because of that, they will kill him inside this lakam, because he was not able to fill all criteria. And they never kill him with maybe with gun, say that toe or a knife. No, it's mystically. So he will sleep and never wake up in the morning. And when it happened that the man, the future king, filled all those steps, succeeded for the ritual ceremony, and also give pregnancy to at least one woman, okay, it's a good thing. And he will, after 9 weeks spent here, he will, he is cleansed of all his past life and dressed in royal clothing. And now they declare it the future king. And now I have a video. And it's not that this arrestation, this ceremony of lakam is very spectacular. The arrestation of the future king. Oh, sorry. So this is the arrestation of the future king. The reportage is in French, so. And the arrestation happened during funeral ceremony, because in the West region, we have, when someone died, we have burial ceremony, we have funeral ceremony. And this funeral ceremony, most of the time, happened later, after the death of the late chief. And sometimes it's 10 years, 15 to 30. So it depends, because the chief, before he's dead, he is kind of testimony, say that when after my life, this son will be my successor. And sometimes it's happened that the successor is very small. And this time the village, the village and all notables are obliged to wait that the the son, the future king, grow at least at age of a teenager, and they will organize this ceremony to arrest him and bring him in the La Camp ceremony. And it's an occasion of a big festivity, a celebration. Sometimes you are in this funeral ceremony, but you don't know when they catch this future king. As you saw in the beginning, it's like this, very spectacular. People, notable, came and catch him and go. This, here he is inside La Camp. Here it is. But this video is it's not a big king. It's because we have degree. So this is one king for 1 degree. Yes, smaller. For the big king, it's not easy to see, to have the video. And it's why you saw one woman was crying. It's his wife. Because when it's the small level, you go there with your wife. But when it's the for the big chefferie, when it's for the
ceremony.
No, not ceremony, chefferie. What is chefferie? When it's the big kingdom, the future king goes there with several women. So this is approximately what La Camp looks like. And it's very long, so I will.
This is the next one over. Yeah. You can hit
skate. Okay.
We'll get back there
close. Okay. Now, the second tradition that I choose to share with you is the cult of schools. The origin of the cult of schools is that Bamileke people are from ancient Egypt. I was very surprised when I prepared this presentation because also me, I thought that we are from Bantu people, but no, we are from Baladi, from ancient Egypt. And the Bamileke people copy and paste this tradition. Because in the ancient Egypt, in the war time, during a period of war time, when people decided to run away, to run because of war, it was not easy for them to carry all the skeleton of their parents, their ancestors. So they decided to take only the head, the skull, and bury the rest of the body. And until now, this tradition is actual. And it's respectful in the Western region. And it's also, how can I say? It's very important. When you believe in your tradition, it's not possible to you to deal without this tradition. And what is it? It consists to take the skull of ancestor or to exhume, yes, the skull is exhumed and buried separately in a small house, and sometimes it's because of many reasons. Sometimes you can make it because you need a benediction from your ancestor, from your parents, grandparents, or great-grandparents. So you can make, because when we remove those schools, we put it in a small house, outside, sometimes inside the house or outside the small house, and make sacrifice in this place. And it can be spontaneous, when you need benediction, when you need your ancestor to open your road, you go there and make a sacrifice with those tools I show you previously. Palm oil, salt, chicken, you make the sacrifice there. And sometimes also it's because the schools are angry Because we have, I say that we have, we believe in our customs. And how do you know how the spirit is angry? It's when in your daily life, nothing work. Maybe you have all qualification for a job. You apply, they never call you. You have, even in fact, you have bad luck in your life. And when you go to ask, I don't understand. Everything doesn't work for me. I don't understand. A tragic practitioner will say that, no, it's because you have the school of your maybe grandmother or grandfather or your ancestor. He's angry. He say he's angry because since you grow, you never give him food or drink, something. So he's angry. And then you go back to the village and make the sacrifice on the schools. Now I'll show you to have an overview of this kind of ceremony. So here is the... Okay, here is this kind of ceremony looks like they are to remove the skull of the ancestor, and after they will remove it, they will clean it, remove all the dirt and the thing, and go inside the house. Put it to keep it inside the house. Because when it's like this, they say that the school is angry because it's raining of it. It's raining and also the sun is too hard on the schools. It's why when they take it like this, they put inside the house with a shelter to protect the school from rain and from dry season. And then after that, they will keep it and make sacrifice. And it's ready for all sacrifice, for benediction, or for ask them if they are angry, to say that, okay, don't be angry again. You see, they remove the skull. And in this video, they say that the important part of the school, when they take it like this, is this down jump? Yeah, jump, yes, this part. If when you remove the school, if you don't see this down jump, yes. If you don't see, it's not good. It means that the person was very, very angry. And because of that, the person hide this part. And now it became very serious to find it. You need only the help of tragic practitioner to find this part. So it's what she is explaining. Yeah. So I can skip to save time. Now they are going in the house to bury it in the house, and this place will be the place of sacrifices for this school. Now this is the house. And if you look careful, you will see the tools, some of the tools I show you. The tree, especially the tree of peace. There is no any ceremony in the West region without tree of peace. Now they are preserving it very well. Before keep it. So, this is tree of peace.
Tree of peace.
Tree.
Oh,
yes, tree of peace. Yes, it's to put it the peace. It's like during wartime, when you show white flag, you say that I need peace. So it's for us, our white flag is this, this tree of peace. So now he is trying to keep it. Okay. This is other thing. Okay. Now the next tradition is Kuga dance. Ah, this is a little bit more joyful. It's Kuga dance. But this dance is really, it's also a mystic dance. This dance is organized in the village by the king, and his notable in order to bring peace to the village by demystifying some wizard who use their power to harm the inhabitant. And it's also a dance of sacrifice to the ancestors so that they guarantee the prosperity, the health, the wealth of the village. So I have a small, a big, a long video, but I will cut it because of time. Here, I can put this. So if you look careful, there is a tree of peace here. And those people, it's not easy to recognize them. And to be a dancer like this, you have to be initiated. It's not everybody, no. It's not everybody. Even when, if your husband is there, it's not easy for you to know that he's dancing, because when they came out like this, they already have those masks, and it's not easy. And I don't know if it's true or just to scare people. They say that those things is hair, dreadlocks hair. And when I was more younger, they say that if one of these dreadlocks hair touch you, it's like a poison. I don't know if it's true. So I'm about this, those hair. It's made with dreadlocks, like dreadlocks. It's hair. So this dance is to bring peace in the village. And it's organized by the chief. And it's only for initiated people. You can do that. Okay, I can stop that. You have an idea of what Kuga dance looks like. Now personal testimony. Okay, now I will tell you my story. And this story is about our custom. What's happened, this story my parents told me because I was very young. And it happened when I was age of two. My mother and my father told me that everything was very well, was good in their life. And at the age of two, normally I was a normal child, and I started working. And then after a while, I stopped working. It was not possible for me to work again. And I was always ill, every day ill. I was very, very small, with a belly fat, a big hair, but all the rest of my body was very thin, very serious, because I was ill. And my parents went with me, with all hospitals. They gave me all vitamin, nothing happened. All thing, nothing happened. And one day, when my mother was walking on the street, going to the market, one woman came to her and said that, hey, this lady, I would like to talk to you. My mother said, okay, what's happened? She said that you have a problem. My mother said, no, I don't have a problem. She said, yes. She said, yeah, you have a problem. My mother said, no, I don't. She said, yeah. She insists and said that, don't you have a child who is ill? My mother said, ah, yes, I have my second, because I'm the second of my parents. I have an elder sister. And the woman said that, your child is ill, and you are wasting your time at the hospital. You are wasting your money for nothing. The solution of this child is not at the hospital. The solution of this child is at the village. So go back to your village and see your grandmother. Because my mother was the first child of her parents and the first grandchild of her grandmother. And she was also the first to get married because my mother got married early. And 1 year after she got married, she gave birth to my elder sister. 1 year later, she born me. And all those times, her grandmother was at the village, and she heard that she has two great-grandchildren. And because of that, she was angry. And when this woman told that to my mother, I said, no, go to the village quickly. Don't waste time, because what you are doing at the hospital is wasting time for nothing. Go see your grandmother. The day after, you know, in Western region in general, we are very superstitious. And when she heard that, there's no time to waste, she said that the day after, she went to the village with my father, and we were together. And my father told her grandmother-in-law that I heard that it's you are disturbing this child. Why do you disturbing this child? She said that, oh, finally you come. And welcome. Note that my grandmother was a tragic practitioner. She was a tragic practitioner. And when my father asked him, why are you disturbing this child? She doesn't do anything for you. She said, no, I'm very angry. Why? I'm angry because I heard that I have one grandchildren. I didn't see her. 1 year later, I heard that I have two grandchildren. I didn't say, you want me to die without so my grandchildren? Why do you want me to die without so them? I'm old. So, my father, she said, okay, no problem. Now that you come here, there is no problem. I'm no more hungry. I'm very happy. And they said that she took me and went with me in her house where she made her tragic practitioner practice. Yes, and she washed me with those tools. I show you some of those tools. I show you, she washed me and speak and say that, okay, I recognize that I was hungry. It's because I was hungry that you started to be ill and stop to walk. And now it's finished. I'm no more hungry. I'm very happy. And I bless you. I bless you and give you all benediction. And okay, go and stay safe. So when she finished, 2 days after, my parents and I came back to the city because we lived in the city and my great-grandmother lived in the village. And they said that when they came back, I start work again. I start work again, and since this time, I grow normally in the land. Until now, I don't know. So I don't know if it's true or not. But we don't ask you to believe. I don't know how to explain it. You don't want you. You have to believe. Yes, you have to believe of those customs. And since this time, everything is very well. And now the conclusion. Bamileke culture in general is the tradition. Our culture is based on tradition in general, and we strongly believe on our tradition. And the meaning of the cult of schools is to elevate the deceased to the status of ancestor, and provides a place among the community of the living. And my reference and. Thank you for your attention.
Questions, I'm sure. Who's first?
Yes.
Cameroon.
Yes.
Is that your original word or somebody gave? Is that the name you called?
Normally, the history say that Cameroon came from Portuguese. The Portuguese, when they discovered Cameroon, they because in Cameroon there was a stream river, yes, and they say that from this stream river they took the name of Cameroon, which means Rio dos Camarões in Portuguese. It means stream river, yes, Rivière de Crevette. So Cameroon came from Portuguese.
But you don't have any other name which you call your people, except the tribe name?
No. We have many ethnics in Cameroon, so no, we don't have a special.
Any significance of nine?
Of nine?
For 9 weeks and nine.
Yes, months. I don't know. But what I know that is in our tradition, the impair, chiffre impair.
Prevent?
Old? Old, yes. In our tradition, old is very important.
Old number.
Yes, old number. So 3, 5, 7, 9. Yes, it's, I don't know why, but I just believe.
Just last question.
Yes.
The kingship, it is not hereditary, right?
It's not?
It's not by birth. You get some people in the...
No, it's by birth.
It's by birth.
Yes, I say that before the death of the actual king,
yes,
he already said to people that after my death, this is my son. This son will be my successor. And it's why inside the Lakam, the future king of the whole village went there with several women because they need that those women get pregnancy of a boy, baby boy, and this baby boy will be the future king. So it's a heritage. It's from father to son.
Okay. Well, I was, that you said some people will come and catch you.
Yes, they catch it because when there is a funeral ceremony is a, like burial ceremony. For example, if your father died, you have to be there.
Yes.
All children have to be there. All women, if he had many women, all women have to be there, all children. And among those children, they will catch one, the son he said before he's dead.
Okay.
So it's because you, it's why you see so this ceremony. And it's always spectacular when it's concerning the king. The future king.
Yeah. Who's to choose the women, nine women?
Those notables in the village.
Notables.
Yes, it's those notables choose the women in the village. And most of the time when they catch one son like this, in general the mother of the son cry. She's crying because she is afraid. She doesn't know if her son will succeed all the steps inside, because if you fail to one step, they will kill you. So when they catch like this, it's very sad for the mother, because she is until the end of those 9 weeks, she's very sad. She doesn't know what will happen with his son inside. Yes, Nasa?
Yeah. I noticed in the video that the tradition to select the kingdom and then also to put the kingdom in the room, as you mentioned, and also the death and the cult of the skull. I saw they all involved men as the leader or the one who managed or did this activity. So I want to know your opinion about this. And I assume that in the Mikkeli tradition, men is more dominant in probably the decision making. I wonder about the role of women in this culture, especially in terms of leadership and in your personal opinion, because you now you're studying here and you also are involved in public area. How do you think the role of women in public sphere, not just in domestic area, in your
You have a great question. And yes, you are right. Normally in our tradition, we are like Muslim people. So the woman in general doesn't have a say regarding tradition. But now with the modernism, with the influence of modernism, because in the past, it was not possible for a woman to succeed to his father. To her father. It was not possible. But now, with the modernism, it tends to be the successor of your father. So I don't know, maybe in the coming years, it will be happy, but till now, it's only men.
You never have queen?
You are queen because you are wife of king, yes. It means that you as a woman was inside this Lakam ceremony and took all those mystic things. No, no.
It's a follow-up question. What if the king and queen they don't have a son? What happens if they only have daughter? Who will?
No, if they have daughter inside Lakam, if they have only daughter inside Lakam, there's no problem. It means that the future king is a viril. And it means that even after Lakam, he will have a son. So it's not, but the ideal will be that the son was conceived inside Lakam. But if it's happened that all those women get pregnancy only for baby girl, no problem. He will, they will introduce him as a future king and he will make certainly a boy after. And this boy, one of those boys could be the future king. You're welcome. Yes?
So you mentioned there are different religions, right?
Yes.
And you said it mostly the Cameroon people live based on traditions.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes based on different religion, traditions also differ. Mm-hmm. So how does it interact? Like people coming from different religion, but they follow certain traditions. For instance, like, the culture of skull.
Yes.
So does it play a role? Religion plays a role or not in this tradition?
No. Bamileke in general are animists. In general. Basically, Bamileke people are animists. So we strongly believe only of our ancestors, of those schools. Now, if I'm Catholic now, my religion is Catholic, it's because of the colonialism. It's because of the colonialism and the, yes, the how do you call it? Yes, it's when white people came in Africa and colonized Africa with religion. But our religion in basically it's animist. So we are not really a Catholic or Protestant or Muslim. No, we are animists. So we believe only on our ancestors and those mostly, especially those school. Yes.
Do they get whether the king's family receive any money or income from the people or from the state, from the government?
To
suppose somebody's made a king, does he receive any money or tax or any revenue from government or from the village?
To support the village or?
For himself, king?
Normally, a king works together with government because a king is part of administrative, it's part of administrative management. In the first video, there was an official divisioner, from this village. He was for this ceremony. 72%. So the king doesn't manage the village without a state or without. Yes. Those are administrative authority. So we are work together for the well-being of the village. But the king is mostly for a traditional part. And those administrative authority are for the law in general. Yes?
Is it possible for king to leave the village?
To?
To leave the village.
Leave?
Yeah, go somewhere.
To leave? Normally not, it's not possible. But if he leave, it means that it was not the person, the right person at the right place. Yes. And sometimes, because now also with the problem of corruption, many people tend to buy, to become king. When it's not, when your father doesn't design you as his successor, you will never stay long at this place. You will die until they will put the right person, the person he said, before his death. So, any question?
Any other thoughts, questions?
Yes.
Thank you. And I have a question about the income. What's the highest income of the Cameroon? Like biggest income?
Yes, Cameroon. Cameroon is the economy of Cameroon is based on agriculture, tourism, and livestock, fishery, hunting. Yes, so it's agriculture, tourism, and livestock in general. Yes, my final thought is just to thank you again. Thank you very much for coming for my presentation. I hope that you like it. I hope that you learn more about Cameroon in general and West region in particular. And if you have any question, even after this presentation, feel free to come see me. Also, I forgot. I have two anecdotes concerning this tradition. When I applied for this Humphrey program, and when I was in the U.S. Embassy in Cameroon, the man who received me, the assistant of the, I think, public affairs, he said that they sent four candidates here in the United States, and I was the only one that they chose. And he said that, I know you Bamileke people. I know that you went to your village and talked to your ancestor. That's why they choose only your candidate, because I don't understand. And the man also, he's a Cameroonian, of course, and he's from the English part of Cameroon. And we have almost the same culture. So we know. She said that, no, I know you went to your village. I said, no, I didn't went to my village. I have my benediction from my was child. She said, no. He said, I know you. You were in the village. And another anecdote, it was with Binta. Yes. Because since this winter season, sometimes I feel shocked. When I touch something, I feel shocked. And I ask also to my friend if they sometimes feel shocked, they say yes. But Binta made me laugh one day because my shock is too much, even from hand to hand. Yes, and one more time, I felt shocked with her by touching. And since this time, when I approached her, She ran away and said, no, 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 go, go. I don't want to be electrocuted. And she said that you have too much power. And she said that I will go to Harvard University and tell her that there is one person with power here. Come take her and bring her to the laboratory to make experience. Because she has too much power. So I like it. It was very funny for me. Though I don't know. Okay, so thank you very much.